Fans approve of daytime Emmys in memoriam. How all awards shows should do it. Joni Wachter was included in the 2024 Daytime Emmy Awards in memoriam segment. With a special tribute presentation, the 2024 Daytime Emmy Awards remembered the stars and legends the industry has lost this year. A solemn in memoriam segment had the audience in tears during the 51st annual Daytime Emmy Awards, which took place at the Westin Bonaventure Hotel and Suites in Los Angeles on Friday, June 7. The segment consisted of a shorter-than-usual presentation that paid homage to some of the notable individuals who passed away in the first half of 2024. As fans noted online, this year's in memoriam covered less than 1 year of industry losses due to the 2023 Daytime Emmys being held a few months ago in December, following a delay due to the WGA and SAG-AFTRA strikes. Among those named in the emotional segment were longtime TV anchor Sam Rubin, Young, and the Restless star Marla Adams, Daytime Emmy-winning soap star Meg Bennett, and General Hospital actress Robin Bernard, among others. The tribute also included the late General Hospital actor Johnny Wachter, who tragically died at 37, just weeks before Friday's ceremony. Wachter, known for playing Brando Corbin on the long-running soap opera, was fatally shot on Saturday, May 25, following an attempted catalytic converter theft in Los Angeles, Calif. Though some fans were confused by names that appeared to be missing in the segment, names that were actually included during the 2023 ceremony in memoriam, most seemed to approve of the presentation. One fan wrote on X, formerly Twitter, that they hope the Oscars take note of how it was done. The focus was only on the people who've passed, and the music underscored it. There was no audio from the ballroom, no singer to focus on, no cutting away. This is how all awards shows should do it. Now this is how you do an in memoriam. Another fan tweeted, excellent job, hashtag DataMemes. Hopefully the other award shows take notice of this beautiful, classy, easily visible spotlight, honoring those that have passed on. Beautiful presentation. Using this subdued, elegant music for the background of In Memoriam was perfect. One fan wrote as another simply said, they got the In Memoriam right. The 51st annual Daytime Emmy Awards presentation aired live on CBS. You can also stream the ceremony live and on demand on Paramount Plus. Next, Melody Thomas got honors Hawaii and our family while accepting Lifetime Achievement at Daytime Emmy Awards. Melody Thomas got honors Hawaii and our family while accepting Lifetime Achievement at Daytime Emmy Awards. Melody Thomas Scott at the 51st Daytime Emmy Awards, held at the Westin Bonaventure Hotel on June 7, 2024 in Los Angeles. Melody Thomas Scott received a special honor at this year's Daytime Emmys, as she was presented with a Lifetime Achievement Award during the ceremony on Friday, June 7. The 51st Annual Daytime Emmy Awards at the historic Westin Bonaventure in Los Angeles, Calif., included a special presentation to honor Melody and her husband, Edward J. Scott, for their contributions to the daytime television industry. Melody, 68, is known for her longtime role on The Young and the Restless, while Edward, 79, is a Daytime Emmy-winning producer on the long-running soap opera. Related, Eric Braden, 83, of The Young and the Restless, cuts a suave figure at Daytime Emmys. During the ceremony, Melody's on-screen husband, Eric Braden, and I and our co-star, Laura Lee Bell, presented the award. Edward shouted out their three daughters, Jennifer, Alex, and Elizabeth, and their spouses, and their five grandkids in his portion of the acceptance speech. Meanwhile, Melody expressed how much her Y and R family has meant to her through the decades. A lot of people have been talking about family tonight on this stage, Melody said at one point. And growing up, this Hollywood kid was family challenged. She continued, when I was cast on Y and R 45 years ago, I whopped on stage 41 at TV City and knew I was finally home with a family that had been waiting for me all along. Edward J.S.